We will discuss about the chapter 9, Social Sciences, Flowering of Regional Cultures. So start about the, what is the flowering of regional cultures? So we will discuss about the, India has always been a land of diversity, with different regionals having unique cultures and traditions. The development and flowering of different regional cultures were deeply influenced by the arrival of new groups into the subcontinent, the intersection of cold and new thoughts, lifestyles and histories was a continuous historical process which presents to this day. In this chapter, we will trace the development of regional languages and cultures from in the medieval period. We will see how the different languages we speak today. You know very well how many languages is used in India: Hindi, Gujarati, English, Sanskrit, Tamil. So many languages is used in India. The lecturer we read, the music and the dance from we enjoy can be traced back to this area. You know well, very well, what does you like sing a song in our languages. The developments, so we will discuss about the development of languages. The development of languages, keywords is, in the medieval period, a number of languages developed. In the medieval period, a number of languages developed. Introduction of Arabic and Persian by the rulers. The introduction of Arabic and perceived by the rulers of the Delhi Sultanate, had a distinct influence of the development of some of these languages. This development also gave birth to a new language called Urdu. This development also gave birth to a new language called Urdu. That is underlined in Urdu. That is the underline in Urdu. Also gave birth to a new language called Urdu. Let us now learn about the languages and literature in medieval India. First language is Arabic. First language is Arabic. Also gave birth a new language called Urdu. First point is Arabic was a dominant language in Central and West Asia because it was the language of Prophet Muhammad. Arabic was a dominant language in Central and West Asia because it was the language of Prophet Muhammad. It was personalized by the Delhi Sultanate. What I am saying? That it was patronized by the Delhi Sultans and by the regional kingdoms. It was personalized. colonized by the Delhi Sultans and by regional kingdoms as well. However, it was restricted largely to regional and philosophical works. The most famous work in Arabic produced in this area was the Fatwa e Alamgiri. The most famous work in Arabic produced in this area was the Fatwa e Alamgiri. The most famous work in Arabic produced in this area was the Fatwa-e Alamgiri, a treatise on law written during Aurangzeb's regime. The second language is Persian. Then let's go for Persian. Persian arose as an important language. Important language in Central Asia. Persian arose as an important language in Central Asia from the 10th century. S-E onwards. The Persian arose an important language in Central Asia from the 10th century in onwards. So we can see easily how is the important languages in Central Asia. Some of the most sin. Scholars. Such as Ferdowsi, and Sadi. What I am saying, some of the most renowned Persian scholars such as who was Ferdowsi and Sadi. Ferdowsi and Sadi. Some of the most renowned Persian scholars such as Ferdowsi and Sadi live between the 10th and the 14th centuries. Some of the most renowned Persian scholars such as Ferdowsi and Sadi lived between the 10th and 14th centuries. Lived between the 10th and 14th centuries. The arrival of the Turks in India led to the introduction of Persian as an administrative language in the country. Introduction. The arrival of the Turks in India led to the introduction of Persian as an administrative language in the country. Scholar of the medieval period was Amir Khusru. Medieval period was was Amit Khushru. This is the most important. This topic is most important. The most prolific person scholar of the medieval period was Amit Khusru. He is between Amit Khusru. Below, between, lived between in 1252 and 1325 SE. He was a leading poet of his time. And was associated with the courts of the associated with the courts of the Delhi Sultanate. He was a leading poet of his time and was associated with the court of the Delhi Sultanate. So student, we will talk about moving further in next video. Okay, bye.